Okay, ladies and gentlemen, if you think that this screen right over here is way too hard to understand, to navigate, and very messy, well, you are in luck, because today they released the article I was talking about in my previous video, about the new personal reserves and how it is going to get the expiration date. Well, the very next day they actually went back and they updated that article, the very next day, according to the community's feedback. Let me actually find it. Where is the updated one? They actually added this line that, taking the discussion on the matter into consideration, we have decided not to make personal reserves from Season 9 base rewards time limited after update 1.18.1, but it is going to happen, but not in the near future. Today, however, they released a more in-depth article about the new personal reserves, and I went over this. This was, was released roughly like 2 hours ago or something like that. I went over this article in depth actually during my live stream, and it was very messy and hard to understand at first. There were so many different opinions in the chat, like what is right, what is wrong, did we understand it correctly? You know, we tried to make sure we understand everything, and today I try to make this as easy for you to understand as possible, because you guys are always saying that thank you, Des, for making those videos, especially about articles like that. They do not even have a video explaining stuff, so I try to make the best work, my best work over here, explaining you what is happening, because you guys say always that you hate reading articles, so I'm here for you. Hopefully you appreciate that. If you do, smash that like button, please, so I know that you would like to see stuff like that in the future as well. Anyway, without further ado, let's jump right into the action, and let me know how we did explaining it. We honestly have some very good things over here as well. For example, able to activate boosters mid-battle. More about that in a second. Anyway, in update 1.18, they will bring a fresh batch of upgrades, including the reworked personal reserves. They are doing it because right now seems like there are some drawbacks. For example, they are hard to locate and navigate through. I honestly do not know what is hard about that. But more about that in a second, guys. We come back to this. There are too many types of them, way too many unusual durations, like 4 or 6 hours, and minuscule bonuses, bonus values like 10 or 15%. Yes, you know, 10 to 15%, you basically do not feel the difference, and me personally, I would prefer 1-hour boosters, actually, because I do not want to be glued down to my BC for 4 hours straight, or 6 hours straight, to use the maximum value of the boosters. If you take a break, you basically lose some value, you know, you lose some time. And I would like to, you know, pop a booster for 1 hour, after that take a little break, you know, come back, pop another one, and so on. And they say, for these reasons, personal reserves too often gather dust in player's depot. Okay. The old way of activating personal reserves was a bit complicated. you will now be able to do it in just a couple of clicks. Okay, let's go back to this. And honestly, they are hard to locate and navigate through. How many clicks does it take for me to activate the booster right now in the current system? 1, 2, 3, and 4. Boom. Done. And I don't know, like, for me personally, it is not super messy, because we can see the value, like everything is separated, crew experience, free experience, credits, different icons, combat experience. For me personally, it is not that hard to navigate and, you know, crazy. But if they are going to make this UI cleaner, activation even easier or more informative, then, you know, what I have against that, right? But this was kind of a funny remark over here. So, the new personal reserves activation and managing screen will be accessible via the top bar in the garage, like, you know, I just showed you as well. Only 4 clicks to activate that. On the screen, you will also see the following: all reserve types available in the game. You know, combat experience, crew experience, free crew and free experience and credits, event reserves and clan reserves, the number of reserves on your account, and the time remaining for each activated reserve. You will also be able to purchase personal reserves directly from this screen, making money. But now, here comes one of the best part in this entire article, ladies and gentlemen. Moreover, you will even be able to activate personal reserves when in the battle. This is actually nice. Just press tab or hit the B key and select a reserve. So, some might say, What's so special about activating personal reserves mid-fight? Under the current rules, if the bonus expires while I'm in the battle, it's still applied to the result. It is going to still, you know, work on the results. Yes, exactly. It works like that. But this is actually very correctly said over here. Well, just imagine if you roll out with no personal reserves activated just as a warm-up, and then the battle goes exponentially well for you. With the current system, we wouldn't be able to capitalize on the your performance. However, this will change with update 1.18, and you will be able to activate personal reserves before the fight is over. The bonus will apply to the results on the entire battle, not just what you earned after activation. So there are actually a couple tricks how you can make your personal reserves, how you can squeeze even more value out from your 1 hour boosters, which every single booster is going to be 1 hour from now on. But imagine, always activate booster at the end of your first battle, at the end of your first battle in the session, guys. Why? Let's say you had a long 10-minute battle. You pop the booster at the end of the battle, you get the full value, and you basically just got extra 10 minutes out of your 1 hour booster, right? Because previously you had to activate it at the start or before the battle. The battle lasted 10 minutes, 10 minutes from your booster already spent, but with this mid battle or the end of the battle activation, you basically can get extra 10 minutes out of that. And on the top, let's say, there are, the old system still works as much as I understand, let's say there is 2 minutes left on your 1 hour booster, you jump into the game, and in the middle of the game, the booster expires. The game is like 10 minutes long. You get like extra 7 or 8 minutes out of that booster. So basically you turned your 1 hour booster into 1 hour and 17, 18 minute booster. You know, just something to think about. Basically, always, if this system works like that, always activate the booster at the end of your first battle, which is giving you some extra value. On the top of that, once the effect of an activated personal reserve ends, you will get a notification showing the amount of extra credits, combat XP, crew experience you gained. Basically a little statistic to show you how it works, right? Next topic, simple and efficient. So to complement the reworked UI, we reviewed and improved the basic mechanics of the personal reserves by streamlining them and increasing their efficiency. All personal reserves will have the same duration, 1 hour. Your questionnaire answers revealed that most players preferred 1 hour personal reserves, so we hope this change will be well received. Now, I did host a poll on the Twitch chat, and over 90% of the viewers actually agreed that they do not mind this, and they agree them turning gold boosters into 1 hour. Because, once again, for the reasons that you get more value out of 1 hour boosters, in a nutshell, with most of the boosters than, 2 hour boosters or 4 hour boosters, because a couple examples. For example, your 1 hour booster runs out. Once again, like the previous example, you have 2 minutes left, you jump into the battle, the battle is long, you get, the extra minutes on the top of that. After that, you can pop another booster and so on. And also, you are not clued behind your PC if you want to take the max value of the booster, like for 4 hour or for 2 hour or for whatever. And there are some rare occasions where this conversion into 1 hour is very bad. For example, we have some crazy boosters, something like the credit boosters, 3 hour, 200% credit boosters. I have never seen that, but this, for example, will be converted into 6 1 hour, 100% boosters. I would say this is way more valuable. This is actually nuts, but this is a very rare occasion. If I would have that, I would be quite mad to see this booster turning into a 1 hour, 100% booster, because this is just absolutely crazy. But how many players do we have in the game who have those, or where were you able to get those in the first place? I don't even know. So, next up, there will only be 3 categories of personal reserves: 4 extra credits for extra combat XP, and combined 1 for crew and free experience. So yes, they are going to combine crew and free experience boosters. So basically now, instead of having 3 slots and 3 boosts, now you have 3 slots, but you get 4 boosts at the same time. You get the boost for combat XP, for crew and free XP, and 4 credits. There will be only two types of personal reserves bonus values, standard and improved. Once again, this is for simplicity and transparency. We believe, blah blah blah, that playing World of Tanks should be about having fun on the battlefield, not about estimating comparative values of various reserves in the depot. Like, this line over here, like, absolutely useless line. That, like, just delete this, because we all know that you made two different boosters: standard, what you can earn; improved, what you can buy. And they say this straight out in the next line as well. Standard reserves will be awarded for taking part in the in-game events and activities. Improved reserves will come from the in-game purchases as part of the premium shop packages. You know, that's straight out. But I do not know any player. I do not know any player who has been on this screen for 30 minutes fighting with him or herself, thinking about which booster should I activate now for 30 minutes and not playing the game, and then Alt F4, quit the game. Like, I do not know any player who has done that, what they said in that line. Like, that was kind of weird. We're going to have improved and standard personal reserves. Standard ones are 50% to combat XP, 200% to crew and free XP, and 50% to credits. And improved ones, 100% combat XP, 300% crew and free XP, and 100% to credits. This is big, because I have never seen higher credit booster than 50% myself on my account, so this will be something new for me. But as I can see, I only need to buy that if I want to get it. Anyway, moving on, soon we're going to talk about the conversion, but first of all, let's talk about the expiration date, what I covered in my previous video as well, what was changed a bit. And what caused a lot of drama, actually. You know, with update 1.18.1, it will be technically possible for standard personal reserves to have an expiration date, after which they disappear from the player's account. Please note that we will not be using this functionality in the foreseeable future. Here is what it means for the players. Improved personal reserves will not have expiration date. Converted personal reserves will not have expiration date. This applies to both standard and improved personal reserves. So basically, all the boosters you have in your garage right now before this conversion are not going to have expiration date. Doesn't matter if it is standard, doesn't matter if it is improved. Battle Pass, well-deserved reward, holiday ops, or any other current and upcoming activities will not distribute personal reserves with an expiration date anytime soon. So basically, I think what is going on over here, maybe they are going to lower the income of personal reserves, like from different events or something, I don't know. And they, you know, just wait until people maybe run lower on those, and then they introduce this feature. But if you have what personal reserves you already have on your account will not be converted into the expiration date boosters. Right. Okay. Finally, let's talk about the conversion. This is what took the longest time to understand, mainly because I was not sure if I'm actually going to get that much value out of the conversion. Me personally, if you have a lot of free experience, high percentage free experience boosters as well, well, this might be the same case for you, but I did talk to the Wargaming guy and kind of confirmed it. Anyway, the conversion basically wants to guarantee that you are not going to lose any value. The combined value of the new personal reserves on your account will be greater than or equal to the combined value of old personal reserves on your account. You know, this is quite obvious, quite a standard thing, what they should do. So, here are a couple examples. For example, the combat experience booster conversion is the easiest to understand. Everything will be turned into 1 hour, as I said. And let's say you have a 2 hour 50% booster, which is going to be turned into a 2 1-hour 50% boosters. Or if you have 7, it will be turned into 14 1-hour standard boosters. And the same about the credits. Like, if you have the low amount of credits with high hours, like 15%, only 15%, it is going to turn it into a 50% booster, but it is going to lower the hour value, of course, just to give you approximately the same value of credits as you would have made in 4 hours, basically saving some time for you personally, right? But once again, over here, the bad example is if you have the 200% booster, I don't know if you would like to give up that. Finally, the biggest... So, no questions about those two, right? This is where we spent the most time with the stream, trying to figure it out, because as soon as we were done figuring it out, there was someone saying, no, Des, you are wrong, and we went over it again, and finally, hopefully, I understand it correctly. So, what do we have? Personal reserves for crew XP and free XP will be merged together into a one personal reserve for both, which is giving you both, so now you can run four boosters at the same time in three different slots, you know, which is a good thing. But how does the conversion work? So, ladies and gentlemen, you have 8 2-hour personal reserves for 300% crew experience and 11 2-hour personal reserves for 300% free experience. After the conversion, you will have 22 1-hour combined personal reserves for 300% to crew and free XP, because it takes the same percentage, same hour, free and crew experience. It will look which has higher value, which of, you know, which booster you have more of. It is going to take that, it is going to ignore the lower number, and you will get what is left. Okay, let me give you a better example. This is the example I asked from the Wargaming contact as well. I made a print screen of my booster page over here, of my personal reserve depot over here. I sent it in and I asked, do I understand this correctly, that I have 300% for 1 hour crew experience booster, 5 of toes. I have 441 300% free experience booster for 1 hour. So those two have the same numbers. Those two are going to be combined. And do I understand this correctly, that I will have 441 300% 1 hour booster for both crew and free XP when this conversion goes off? And they said, given the example in the article, yes, you should get 441 1 hour 300% free and crew experience booster. This, if like, I still do not believe it before I see it on my account. I legit do not believe it before I see it on my account, because this is actually massive value. Why? Because a free experience booster is so much less valuable than crew experience. 300% crew experience boosters are actually hard to come by. At least, as you can see, I have very low amount of toes, and you know, very hard to get, to be honest with you. But if this will be turned into 441, for me personally, I'm getting massive value. So hopefully, guys, it makes sense. If you have, just look at the same numbers, what you have, 300%, 300%, look which has the higher value, you should be able to get that. This is how I understand it, and this is how the conversion system over here looked like as well. You know, I have like 441. 441 of toes, and I'm going to get 441 of toes, which is, you know, white nuts value if you ask from me. So this is how the conversion works. Hopefully explained it maybe better than over here. And here is all the values as well, if you want to take a look. Like, if you have weird numbers, like, you know, where do we have some weird numbers? Like 75% free experience for 2 hour. What are you going to get? You are going to get 200% 1 hour, and you actually, you know, win value pretty much. So yes, ladies and gentlemen, new personal reserves. What do you think about all of this? Everything boosted, or everything changed to 1 hour. Now you are able to activate it during the battle, which is nice. Do different types. Improved, you know, this is quite pay to win-ish. This is quite pay to win-ish, ladies and gentlemen, right? What else? Improved, you know, will not have expiration date. Converted will not have expiration date, so you do not have to worry about that. Yeah, let me know. A lot of things to, you know, to discuss. Let me know in the comment section your thoughts, what you have about all of this, and let's have a little discussion going on over there in the comment section. I thank you so much for tuning in. Hopefully this video was a bit more helpful, maybe explaining it. It was not going to be the shortest video, because we had actually a lot of things to simply talk about over here and to explain. Hopefully I did decent work. Let me know. I get you next time with something else. Be beautiful, stay sexy, take care, and bye.